I've had this Mercedes 300D for about a year now, and the tachometer has never worked. With this generation of Mercedes from the late 70s up to about 85, they have this tachometer port in the engine bay, and the tach amp plugs into it. At first I found a used one at a junkyard, but that didn't work. And the old way was to crack this thing open and you scrape the silicon sealant off of the little board and you resolder the board and you put it back together. And about 10 years ago, someone was making these little microprocessor replacements. They're really cool, but then they went away. So I gave up. I was like, I'm just not gonna solve this problem. But now someone else is making them again, and you can find them on eBay now. Very cool. So when you start up the car, you're supposed to get this sweep of the needle through the entire range of the tach display, and you get an indicator light that tells the unit is working, and you also get a blinking light that's a signal from the sensor on the front of the engine. So I plugged this thing in, I was getting the power light, and I was getting the sensor light, but I was seeing nothing at the gauge, so I started to tear apart the car to figure out what signals were going from the amp to the display. I had some other stuff behind the dash I wanted to do as well, so I took out the cluster.
Speedometer cable. Ah. That's weird. Okay, it's free.
First, I'm trying to figure out where the connector plugs into the display, what's going on there. Is there some change in voltage when I turn on the ignition? The connection mark W is the signal, and I wasn't getting anything there. And then there's 12 volts going to the bottom of the connector, which I don't really understand why they would need that, but on the signal side, I got nothing. So at this point, what I'm not getting is that the pulse isn't really measurable by a plain old volt ohm meter. It's not a changing voltage, it's a variable frequency pulse that's only 3 milliseconds long. So as I researched this, I realized, this is something I could probably see if I had an oscilloscope. And I thought, geez, I sure wish I had an oscilloscope. Well, it turns out I do have an oscilloscope. I bought one of these $25 kits on Amazon a few years ago, and I soldered it up myself. I just never thought I would use it on a car. It's not like a real oscilloscope, but when I tried measuring the signal between the ground, which is pin 4, and the signal, which is pin 3, sure enough, you can see the little square wave there. So yeah, it's definitely working. It's putting out that pulse. So I put the instrument cluster back in the car so I could actually run it. If you try running the engine with the cluster removed, the oil sender line has nowhere to go, and that'll squirt oil all over the inside of the car, and you don't want that. But when I'm running the car, I'm still not getting a signal at the plug in the dash. So finally, I open up the connector where the amp plugs into, and what I'm finding inside is that there's a ground, and then there's 12 volts, and then on the bottom three pins, that's where the sensor plugs in, and that's all good, but on the top crown section of the plug, there's just nothing on pin 3. And that's where the signal goes out from the amp to the display. So now I'm even more confused. Why is there no signal line? Where is it? So I'm like tearing kick panels off, and I'm following wires into harnesses.
Where does it come from?
And finally, I make a phone call to the guy who designs the amplifier, which is very nice. If you buy one of these amplifiers, he gives you his email address and you can contact him. And he says, you know, maybe you have an 85. I said, no, it's an 84. He goes, well, maybe you did an engine swap or something, but 84s sometimes have this setup as well. And I just couldn't believe that I had this alternate later setup, but it turns out that I do. On the later cars, they don't actually use the tach amp at that port. There's actually just a little cap there, and it's just a port for the technician to plug diagnostic tools into. But on my car, someone had an amp plugged into it when I bought it. So I just assumed that this is the earlier setup. But sure enough, if you look down in the filthy recesses on the back of the engine, there's a sensor line coming out of there. So now I know all the cars have this port in the engine bay, and they all connect to an RPM sensor in the front of the engine. It's very misleading if you're trying to figure out why this amp isn't working. Well, on the later engines, there is no amp there. There's just a cap. If you look closely at the connector in some of the earlier clips, you can actually see very clearly that there's no receptacle for pin 3. It's just a dark hole. So I think the lesson is don't make assumptions if there's an amp plugged into your port. If you have this later setup, then there are three places to look for failure. The first is the connector on the firewall. So where the sensor comes out, it connects to this little clip on the firewall. And in my case, this looked clean. Then it goes through the firewall and into the EGR computer. This is the second place to look for bad connections. This car is pretty rust-free. It's really clean under here.
Well, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that this is probably not the culprit.
And the third point of failure is behind the glove box. There's a little relay back there. It's called the over-voltage relay, or OVP. I think this has something to do with protecting the electrical system if you have an alternator failure. So in that relay, there's a 10-amp fuse, and I pulled it out, and sure enough, that fuse was blown. So I replaced the fuse, I hooked up the tach to the connector, started up the car, and boom, suddenly the tach is working.
Yes!
So all that hunting around, it was based on the assumption that if I had the tach amp there, I must have one of those earlier setups. And I thought, oh, I would have to have the 85 car with the smaller air cleaner and the trap oxidizer and all that. That would make it a later car. But actually, the boundaries on how these cars are changing from one year to the next, it's not really that clearly defined. You get some changes in some parts and other parts stay the same. And one other thing about this little relay up there, I think you probably don't even need to remove the glove box to get at this. I think you could just remove the lower kick panel, reach up there, and pop it out to replace that fuse. I'm not sure. One more interesting thing is that I think if you measure the signal going to the back of the tachometer display, I think that's just the raw pulse from the sensor. I don't think that there's even an amplified signal going in there. I think there's actually the amplifier is built into the tach display itself. And that kind of explains why there's, you can see there's boards and timers. And that also explains why there's a constant 12 volts going into it as well. But I'm not really sure if there's like a earlier and later version of the tach display. So in the end, I'm happy that it works. I also changed the cluster lights to LEDs, and those are a massive improvement.